Hi everyone, it's Traci with Traci's Paws. I want to apologize first for being a little delayed. I actually took a friend to have a sinus procedure done and it took a little longer than expected. And then with the traffic, I'm still not home. So I decided I just dropped her off. I would just do the Facebook Live from my car before I get home, or it'll be another 45 minutes. But thank you very much. I hope you are okay and not upset with me too much. Anyway, this is our second vlog in our series, The Paws Spot. And it's where I'll discuss upcoming pet-related holidays, days of observance, and provide you with information and some tips on pet safety. So tomorrow, if you're in San Diego, you will maybe not everyone will be going, but tomorrow we'll be having our Pride Parade, which is actually one of the largest Pride Parades that's celebrated in the United States, which is pretty cool. So this year we actually have over 250 organizations walking in the parade supporting our LGBTQ+ community, which is really cool to me. I love that we have so much support in San Diego. But that also means we'll have more animal-related organizations walking in the parade, and since it is pet-friendly, we'll have more people joining us with their dogs at the event. So I just would like to reach out to everyone and say, hey, it's going to be a great day, but it's also going to be warm, and this is an opportunity to kind of plan and be ready for tomorrow. So with over 250 organizations walking, that means the parade will probably be 3 to 4 hours long, closer to 4 hours. So the hours of the event will be probably from 11 to 4, and the temperatures are going to be in the high 70s, low 80s. So when you think about the outside temperature, the ground temperature is actually warmer. So you need to be prepared. You'll need to make sure that your dogs, if you bring your dogs, that you either maybe have a wagon with you with a little umbrella for shade. And also, if you want, you can put those little doggy boots, not the cute ones that look really cute, that look kind of like deflated balloons because they're just not enough protection, but some nice thick little doggy boots. You can also bring a harness or a sling that you actually have on you, where your dog is kind of like on your person. And then, or you could just opt to carry your dog. So, and the last option would be just to maybe be prepared to leave the parade early if it gets too hot. A good test for you is just throughout the day, wherever you're standing, if it's on the asphalt or the sidewalk, put the back of your hand on the ground for a full 5 seconds. And this is not a contest. Oh, can I keep it down for 5 seconds no matter what? No. You're going to be keeping your pet in mind and thinking, okay, in the 5 seconds I have my hand down, is it too hot for me? If it's too hot for me, and if I can't keep my hand down for the full 5 seconds, then you need to remember that your dog can't handle that either. Their little pads start to burn really quickly, and it's just, you should Google what their pads look like. It's very pitiful. So anyway, but just, you know, just thinking ahead, you can bring a wagon, especially for people in the parade. We'll probably have wagons anyway. It's a great idea. It keeps your pets off the ground. It's easier. Also, there will be a lot of people around. So if you do bring your dog as an attendee, just be careful. Make sure they're on leash so they don't get loose. I don't think we have any fireworks, but we do have some motorcycles at the beginning of the parade, which could frighten your dog. So just like we talked about the 4th of July fireworks, just make sure that you have them close to you. Don't let them be too loose on their leashes to get in the way of other people. And also bring some water with you. If you decide to bring them and go to a bar afterward, make sure they have a pet-friendly patio. Most of them in Hillcrest do. But anyway, tomorrow, if you're ready to go, it could be a really great day and a lot of fun for you and your dog. Tomorrow, nationally, is another day that we observe. It is Pet Fire Safety Day. So on this day, we try to prevent home fires that are accidentally started by your pets. I also touched a little bit on this last week, but there are nearly 1,000 house fires started every year accidentally by the pet, which is really sad and scary. Unfortunately, I was going to meet with Captain Amador, but there just was not enough time for him to meet with me. But he did say that he's at a local fire station in San Diego. He vividly remembers a call that he went to where the house burned down completely, and it was because of the family pet. The little chihuahua had tried jumping up on top of the stove and accidentally turned it on. So some things we can do there to prevent that is to, one, you can remove the stove knobs. That way, if a pet does try to jump up, it will not be able to turn it on. You can also, if you have a door to your kitchen, you can close your door. Or you can also make sure that you have a secure area like a pen or a baby gate something that's tall enough that your dog cannot jump over. I know if you have a cat, it might be more difficult, but just do the best you can. So this should help a lot for protecting against anything in the kitchen. If you do not have those items, if you're not able to secure the kitchen or like close it off, make sure that you do not have any food or pet related toys or kids toys anywhere near the stove. Something that will attract the dog or cat to try to make it go up and play and accidentally turn it on. Another thing you can do is to make sure that you do not leave any open flames unattended. That goes for candles. There have been stories about house fire starting, a cat walking by and swishing it, and it's very sad because you don't want your pet to be burned or injured either, but it can easily start with just its tail and then hit something else and just create a really bad fire in the home. Also, fireplaces, fire pits, barbecue grills that we touched in last week, make sure that you do not leave those unattended. And if you do have pets around, to please keep them at least 3 feet away. So these are a few things, a few tips. I know there are some more, but these are kind of the most important ones that I wanted to touch on. If you have any other ideas, hi Monica, I hope you're feeling better. If you have any other ideas, feel free to go ahead and send them in, type them in under this right now if you'd like, and I'll research it. And if it's something that is medically approved, I would be happy to go ahead and include it in our blog that'll be on our website later. So anyway, these are a few ways you can prevent a home fire with your pet. So I hope that everyone tomorrow has a great day, whether you're in San Diego enjoying our Pride Parade and celebrations, or whether you're just out with your family, just to kind of remember what you can do to prevent fires and to keep your pet safe. So thank you a lot for joining me today. I appreciate it. I apologize for being late. I'm sorry it's kind of in my car right now, but anyway, I wanted to get it in before it got much later. Thanks, everyone. Thank you for your support. Remember to like us on Facebook and Instagram, and hope to see you soon. Bye.